The ocean is a dynamic and powerful force. It's wonderful to play in, but there are dangers, and rip currents are our number one cause of drownings in the U.S. A rip current is a channel of water moving away from the shore. It's most often caused by breaks in the sandbar or obstructions in the water, such as piers and jetties. The problem with rip currents is they're extremely difficult to spot. If you're in the water, it's basically impossible. If you're out on the beach and you're knowledgeable about rip currents, you may be able to see one. Look for discoloration in the water, murky, debris-filled water, or foamy water that's moving away from the shore. Any day you can have rip currents, but on days where we have higher waves and higher winds, the chance for rip currents increases. Rip currents do not pull people under, they just pull them out. If you're comfortable, swim parallel to the shore. When you're not being pulled out anymore, you can easily swim back towards the shoreline. If you're not comfortable with that, just keep floating, raise your arms and yell for help, the lifeguards will come and get you.
So this time of year, we see an increase in persons in the water search and rescue cases. I think a lot of these are preventable by following our boating safety tips. Always check the weather before you head out, especially the rip current forecasts. Beach conditions can change rapidly, so keep up to date. Another good tip to follow is never swim alone and always use the buddy system. When you have kids in the water, make sure there's an adult nearby to respond if they're in trouble. The best tip I can give you is always head to a beach where a lifeguard's on duty. The Coast Guard is always ready to respond with its partner agencies like the local lifeguards. But the best search and rescue case is the one that doesn't have to happen. So have fun this summer and head to the beach, but do so safely.